monsters.
You're welcome to try.
Think fast. He thought too fast.
You are no match for me.
Let's end this.
Hi, this is Marc Morrell from ToonBarn. We're here at WonderCon 2019. We're talking about Batman versus TMNT. I'm here with Eric Bauza, Leonardo.
It's always good to see you guys. You guys are like one of my faves at these events. And
thank you.
I enjoy the work that you guys do. And you guys always cover the good stuff, clearly. Yes. We're here. Yes. Yeah.
You're always in the good stuff.
Well, I mean, I'm lucky. I must have paid someone $5 down the road to get me here.
So where are your ninjatos?
I don't know. I mean, like, they're around here somewhere.
Shinobi swords.
I can't. I had to check them at baggage.
Right. WonderCon has weapons.
They're a little sharp. You know, I can't carry dull ones around. They're definitely they're over my fireplace.
Didn't I just see you as Splinter in Rise of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles?
I think that was the last conversation we were having was for Rise of the TMNT. I get to play Master Splinter. In the 2012 Ninja Turtles, I get to play Tiger Claw, which is a so it's bad guy, good guy, good guy. So maybe bad guy next. I don't know. I keep telling people I would love to play Krang or April O'Neil. Was the last character I have to play is.
What you really need is you need a mashup between Looney Tunes and TMNT, so you can do every character.
Well, no, I couldn't do that, but that would be interesting. TMNT Looney Tunes, sure.
First base, Bug Bunny. Second base, Bugs Bunny. Third base, Leonardo. Fourth base.
That's right, Doc. Say, where'd we get these nunchucks?
I would love to see that.
Daffy Duck eating a slice of pizza. That's like the messiest animated scene ever, right? Like,
do you have a favorite pizza?
Well, yes, I do. Let's see. What would Daffy have on a pizza? That's a good question. I don't know. You know.
How about Leonardo? New York style?
Just classic thin pepperoni, I think. Yeah. Just a straight edge kind of guy. You know, he's no Michelangelo. He's not putting ice cream or sushi on his pizza.
Well, we're looking forward to Batman versus TMNT right after this. And then everybody else can get it on digital on May 14th. And then on Blu-ray on June 4th.
June 4th. I'm still like the hard copy tangible. I love owning the Blu-ray disc with the cover still. You know, I look forward to collecting that one. As much as I love working on it, I'm always a fan first. I love playing with these toys as kids, and now I get to see it like actually happen in real life in 2019. It's incredible.
Thank you for joining us on ToonBarn. I appreciate
it.
That's all, folks. Yeah.
Some weeks I think I'm a rat.
Other weeks I think I'm a turtle.
And sometimes I think I'm a rabbit.
I think for this version of Leo in particular, it's just the closest thing I've ever done in an animated anything that was just my own voice. So as far as playing, you know, some like a teenager that shows vulnerability, I showed vulnerability with just like not having to disguise my own voice, and it was actually kind of lent itself to the role. Leo, of course, in this version, he is definitely back to basics as the leader of the Turtles. And I mean, he, around his brothers, is kind of like, if it was like a comedy group, he would be the straight man. And I feel like just playing him, and then the ultimate straight man though is Batman. So how much, you know, I couldn't get any more closer than you know, Leo was at the max, and then Batman. We're close enough. Close enough. We didn't get to record together, and I wish we did. Troy is so handsome. But yeah, I get to voice Leo for this. Quite the honor, because clearly, as a fan first, it delivered on all points, I think. So kudos to the directors and the producers over there. But yeah, great. It's my piece on Leo.
This is a big score, gentlemen. It's a bat! Fire! Fire!
Do I look like a friggin' bat to you?
Huh? You are no match for me.
Let's end this.